Did you know that you can build powerful AI agents without breaking the bank? Let's explore how local language models can save you money while delivering results. In this video, we are diving into the world of cost-effective AI agents using local language models and Ollama, giving you the tools to create your own AI solutions. So the year 2025 is shaping up to be the year of agents. At the same time, there is a growing push for local models and edge computation. But there aren't many local models that can handle function calling particularly well. And when it comes to cost efficiency, privacy, and accessibility, that's a big deal. Join me as I take on the challenge of building cost-effective AI agents using local language models and Ollama, and let's see if I can do it without breaking the bank, or my laptop for that matter. Now, a quick backstory. In a recent video, I explored building a research agent using GPT-4o Mini. The reason is that OpenAI models dominate Berkeley's function calling leaderboard, and 4o Mini was not only highly capable, but also the cheapest option in its class. For that project, I designed the agent to interactively refine outputs by asking the researcher follow-up questions. Iterations like this improve output quality, but truth be told, longer runs with cloud-based LLMs can rack up the bills really quickly. A comment on that video got me thinking, what about local options? So I decided to experiment and explore. I already had Ollama installed on my Mac, so I revisited Berkeley's leaderboard again, and this time hunting for non-proprietary options. That's when I found Qwen-2.5 72 billion instruct model, almost toe-to-toe with GPT-4o Mini. Naturally, I pulled it onto my machine through Ollama. It's a 47GB model, so yes, it's a hefty model and it demands a machine with a serious amount of RAM. But once it's up and running, I cloned my previous agentic project, links in the description if you want to follow along, and fired it up in LangGraph Studio. If you're following along, you need to add a .env file at the root of the project with placeholder values like ABC, for example, for OpenAI API key and Tavily API key. This is because LangGraph Studio compiles the project at the time of opening the project itself, and since we built it using OpenAI models, it is looking for that key in the environment variables. Although in this specific case, OpenAI will not be used. With that setup, I reopened the project. It is using chat OpenAI class, but I'll replace it with chat Ollama, and this comes from the LangChain Ollama package, so I'll add that in the requirements. I'll specify the model name as Qwen-2.5-72B instruct. You can run Ollama LS on your terminal to get a list of model names installed on your machine. Things are pretty smooth so far, only it didn't work. You see, LangGraph Studio is running inside a Docker container, and Ollama is running on my host machine, that is my Mac. Now, I could run Ollama in Docker, but on Mac, due to the fact that Docker doesn't support GPU pass-through, it means that it will come with a significant amount of performance hit, something I would definitely want to avoid with a 72 billion parameter model. To solve this, I needed Docker to communicate with the host machine instead of localhost. If I use host.docker.internal as the base URL in the chat Ollama constructor and specified Ollama's default port as 11.434, with that tweak, everything worked. But here is the next challenge. Qwen-2.5 was just too large for my machine. My fans were roaring and my setup was just struggling to keep up. If your machine can handle it, definitely give it a try and let me know how it works. For me though, I needed something smaller. It did work though. The tool calls were indeed generated, but it took almost forever to run, so I had to quit the process. I pulled Llama 3.2 next, a lightweight 2GB model with only 3 billion parameters, racking up a BFCL score of 67. But it is a BFCL version 2, which means it's a single turn function calling benchmark. Just a mental note as we move on. I pulled it onto Ollama, swapped the model name, and created a new thread to test it out. This time, things were much faster and tool calling worked smoothly. However, the chart generator didn't function as expected. To simplify things, I decided to remove the chart generator from the prompt completely and focus on a basic use case for tool calling alone. I went ahead and searched for a comparative analysis of US and Chinese economies, and the tool calling worked perfectly. So here's the takeaway. We can create cost-effective AI agents with local language models and Ollama to build extensive AI agents without the hefty price tag. However, with smaller models, we'll need to break down the task more systematically. For example, use one agent to identify the research topic and break it into specific questions. Deploy a second agent, a search agent for that matter, focus solely on tool calling using a model specialized on tool calling itself that will provide answers to those questions. Finally, have a third agent whose only job is to convert text into JSON, which will convert the list of charts and corresponding data into a JSON list object. But that will be a full project tutorial covered in another video. In this one, I just wanted to show you how you can build these agentic workflows just by using locally hosted LLMs with Ollama so that you can run them for extended periods without worrying about token costs. I'll leave a link to this repo itself under the video along with my other videos on LangGraph and Ollama. in case you want to test out this specific local agentic setup on your machine. If you do, please comment which model worked best for you, or if you'd want me to do a more comprehensive analysis of all the OpenWare's models in terms of their tool calling capabilities, let me know that as well. If you found this video helpful, be sure to check out my other videos on AI development and leave your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in my next video.